you look at our coast, you see that if you want to travel by car from the southernmost point to the northernmost point, you have to make very many fjord crossings, and you do that by ferry. The heaviest polluters in the state of Norway is in fact ship traffic. We have relatively few cars compared to the size of our country. We are only 4.5 million people living here. When the Norwegian government wrote out for quotations for a new ferry system, they imposed that these ferries should have the minimum possible emission which is available in the marketplace today, knowing very well that lean burn gas engines would be their choice. We were contacted by the technical consultants to the ferry company. The power requirement for these ships, the number of engines required for redundancy and so forth, suited our K engine power range perfectly. Compared to a diesel engine of the same power output, the lean burn gas engine, the K gas engine, will give you only 10% the NOx emission of a comparable diesel engine, and it will give you between 10 and 20% lower CO2 emissions.
We are using pure natural gas, and we have the biggest and the best and the highest efficiency spark-ignited lean burn gas engine in the market today.
What we achieved here was not just a conversion from one fuel source to another, but it was also to go to a lean burn combustion system. In order to burn the fuel, we need to increase the air to fuel ratio. Now, the first problem that you encounter when you do that is that the fuel won't ignite. So to overcome that problem, we introduced a separate pre-chamber where you're able to have a richer mixture, so a lower air-to-fuel ratio. You can ignite that with a spark source, and then the flame projects into the main part of the combustion process. To control the amount of fuel coming in and the amount of air coming in such a precise manner required two other forms of technology: a variable vane turbocharger geometry and a very high response control system. And as a result, we now have a world-beating high efficiency gas engine.
It's much, much less pollution. It's quiet, you don't hear anything almost.
When we're in the engine room, you don't have any smell of oil. It's very clean. And for us working around the engines all day long, it's better for the health of the crew.
We hear a lot of people come talking and they don't see any exhaust or anything, so they really like it.
We now also see that a lot of gas stations are coming more and more, the whole Norwegian coastline into the Baltic area. And for sure, when the gas is available, you will also see that there will be vessels that will be built for purely gas operation.
We have to develop our engines so they satisfy not only today's limitations in emissions, but we also have to aim at continuing that development to meet the goals that are set for 3 years from now, 2010, 5 years from now, 10 years from now. So it is, I think, every combustion engineer's responsibility to do whatever he can, and as a company, Rolls-Royce, to do whatever we can to contribute to improvement of our products in that direction.